Renal cell carcinoma is a very heterogeneous disease. In this disease, some patients may have a benefit from a radical resection of the metastasis. But it's important to select patients having limited tumor burden and good prognostic factors. Until now, the role of a medical treatment after a metastasectomy is not well defined. So this represents an unmet medical need. What approach for this patient having high risk of relapse? Until now, no evidence using every agent, no prospective data. So the rationale is targeted therapies is supported in advanced disease. Why not? Can be able to delay the appearance of mets or to cure patients? RESOR trial was a randomized open label phase 2 trial. So was designed to test the first multi-kinase inhibitors sorafenib over observation in a population affected by advanced renal cell carcinoma after a radical resection of the metastasis. The main hypothesis was to improve the recurrence-free survival, to delay the appearance of mets, and so to improve the overall survival. Overall, the study is negative because sorafenib did not improve recurrence-free survival over observation. On the other hand, we need to look at all characteristics of this clinical trial because the limited sample size of the population, the heterogeneity of the study population, and the early termination of the trial suggests to consider with very caution the general results. So, of course, the study should be considered negative, but this study supports some important consideration. In my opinion, two main considerations. First one, we need to focus on a more homogeneous population. For example, patient having a single site metastasectomy, specifically located in site with less unfavorable prognosis, such as lung or glands. And the second key point is represented by the choice of the drugs. Because using sorafenib, many patients required a dose modification and a lower dose dose was associated with less evidence of a benefit. Theoretically, the main reason could be the lower dose dose, first one. The second key point could be the mechanism of action, because the activity of sorafenib could be related to the treatment exposures. So at the stop of the treatment, theoretically, the benefit will be missed. So other reason, the toxicity profile of sorafenib, that represented a major issue in the overall management in this specific population, because this population had no evidence of a disease and had a very, very less acceptance of some adverse events. In my view, RESOR trial suggests two main considerations. To put attention and pay attention to specific homogeneous population. In our trial, the study population was very heterogeneous, while this study may support further investigation, but in more restricted patients, having, for example, a single site, homogeneous site of disease. I suppose only lung mets, only one lesion located on lung. This is the first consideration. The second consideration, we need to look at one other agent. I think PD-1, PD-L1 inhibitors in the same setting because the tolerability, the toxicity profile of this agent is quite different and that may permit to treat well patients for 1 year. And this may be very, very attractive in terms of overall results.